the problem comes many of the times that I have to design a system, but I don't know the hardware. Even I don't know the software. So how to start then? Because I have innovated something, I have to design something, but I don't have enough knowledge of C, or maybe I don't have enough knowledge of Python or any language. So how to start then? So we have various rapid application tools available through which you can start at least. You can start doing certain some applications, and by the side, you can also start learning the exactly so that you can implement the industrial things also, because the rapid application tools give you a platform to start, to design up to a level and to simulate and all those things. But once you are designing any kind of industrial application, you have to have a knowledge of a language also. So today we have just kept one thing, one tool, that Circuito tool that we Himanshu had discussed in the beginning. So I will show you that how I can use this Circuito tool to solve a small problem that I have written over here. This is the problem statement I have, that I want to design an IoT enabled real-time weather information system, that what is the right now, the temperature is there in my room, what is the humidity level in my room, what is the rain value, what is the pressure value, all these things that I want to gather, and I want to send the alert also in this using this platform. So what are things that I require? My task is to gather the data from my room. So I require any kind of a sensor. So I have a sensor over here, like DST11 or DST22 sensor is there. So it is a temperature and humidity reading sensor. So my one problem is solved, that I have a sensor available. Now I require a board, so that it can process the data which is gathered from my sensor, and it can send it to the cloud. So I have this NodeMCU board available at my home, luckily. So I am using this NodeMCU board for you. Thereafter, so Arduino IDE is there, because I need to write some code also. So Arduino IDE is there, because this NodeMCU board is compatible with Arduino IDE to be used. And I don't know much about coding, maybe. This Circuito .io tool available. So I will let you know that how to use this Circuito.io tool. And thereafter, I have to send this data to any server platform. So I have a platform, this ThingSpeak server available, where I can plot the data and send the data on a cloud. So I can later it get also, because it remains stored over there. And alerts and notifications that you can design using this IFTTT platform is there, that I've discussed previously also. So let's use this IFTTT, this Circuito platform. I hope this Circuito.io is available, visible to everyone now. So this is the ID, is there, Circuito.io. And this is the interface. So it has listed the kind of boards, and thereafter the input tools. This is the output tools are available. Thereafter the connectivity and supplies and all these things are there. So I have in the presentation, I have discussed that I'm using this NodeMCU tool. So I have this controller is available, and I'm selecting a controller. So this NodeMCU is here, and I'm selecting this. And I have for input, I have DST. So I have this sensor. So I don't know actually writing the code. So I have just dragged and dropped my these two things that I will be using. And luckily you can see that code has been written in the behind. So this is the code that has been written. And I need to just download this code and to feed into my hardware. I have hardware available, I can show you. And I have told you that I need to send this data to any server. So I configured this, this code over here, and I have opened it into Arduino, that you can see. And I have configured my Wi-Fi, and thereafter this channel and the ThingSpeak and all of those things. And here is this ThingSpeak configuration. So I have this ThingSpeak configuration that you can see over here, and the data is I have fed into my hardware that I can show you. I have the hardware in my hand. So this is the board that is available in my hand, if you can see. And on your screen, you can see that it is sending the data. It is I am recording the temperature and humidity, both the things. So in the real time, it is like it is 5 hours and 8 minutes. So you can see the data, some data has come. It is some it is not calibrated now, because it is just starting that I'm doing with you. So thus some data is coming. So this is how, once you will calibrate, the sensor will start sending the actual values. So this is how the application can be designed, that first you go to the Circuito, you have dragged and dropped the items, and you downloaded the code, you opened it into your Arduino, and you can thereafter load it into your this board and configure the ThingSpeak server. So this is it.